IES stands for Illuminating Engineering Society, which has defined a file format for describing the distribution of light from a light source. In simple words, it's essentially a text file that outlines how intense a light will be in any direction. Now, let's see how you can get IES files to use in Blender. So, you can go to this site, IESlibrary.com, and get your IES file to use in Blender. The link to the website is in the video description. You can see there is information about IES Lights. Just click Browse Library. Here, we can see there are lots of options. I'm going to show you how to download and use this file in Blender. So, select the IES light that you like and click on it. Once clicked, you can see the name of the light, its power, which kind of light it is, and what's its energy value in Blender. So, in order to download this file, just click the Download IES button and save the file. See you in the next one. Hello everyone, I'm going to teach you how to use that IES file in Blender that we downloaded last time. You can follow along with me and download the Blender file given in the description. As you can see, I have four point lamps in the scene and a wall behind it. To see the lights in action, I'm going to change three point lamps to different IES lights. So, you can see the difference between IES lights and a default lamp light. In order to apply IES lights to point lamps, we need to select the point lamp and then go to the node editor. Shortcut for that is Shift plus F3. Now, in the node editor window, press Shift plus A to add a property. You can see a list of categories. Go to texture and then select IES texture. Now, in the IES texture window, select external and then click on the folder icon. Locate your IES file, then connect the FAC to strength of emission. That's it. IES properties are now implemented in your point lamp. Let's do it for the other lamps. I have set three lamps with different IES files. Now let's see this in rendered mode. As you can see, I have three lights of different IES files used on the same point light. You can see there's a huge difference between all these lights now, and each of them can be suitably used in different scenarios. Before we go, we'll make the exact render of the lobby with IES light. All you have to do now is in your Blender file, just go to the outliner window. There is an object called brick wall. Just unhide it to see it in the scene. Now, you can see there is another wall in the scene. Press the zero icon on your numpad or click on the toggle camera view button. Now you can see the exact same scene in your camera view. Now press F12 and it starts rendering. After the render is finished, you can see the result that looks like this. Now it's your turn. Go and make a cool render like this on your own. Thank you everyone for taking our course. We try our best to make courses like this so that you can keep learning new stuff. I want to say a big thanks to William and the entire EduGraph Ideas team for making this course. Thank you.